Why are there so many temporary files in Windows? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got. Why are there so many temporary files left behind each time the computer is shut down and restarted? There are indeed many temporary files. Many temporary files. My primary machine, last I looked, had something like 322 files in its temporary folder, adding up to about 58 megabytes. The example PC we will look at here in just a moment. Just as there are many files, there are also many reasons they might get left behind. First, let's look at why we want temporary files at all. As the name implies, it's a file that is on your hard disk, intended to essentially go away at some point. When a program finishes using a temporary file, it's supposed to delete it. You're never intended to actually see it. Programs will actually use temporary files for a variety of reasons. One of the common ones is needing to operate on more data than is practical to keep in RAM. Data that preserves the state of the software over time. Data that might be used to implement features like undo or redo in applications. Logs, transaction logs, journals, internally managed caches, and more. And of course, whatever else I haven't thought of that a program designer might want a temporary file for. Like I said, the intent is that they go away, they get cleaned up at some point. The reason we're here, of course, is that, well, all those good intentions aside, that doesn't always happen. Let's have a look at some temporary files. I'm here in Windows 10. What I'm going to do here is roughly the same in Windows 11. I'm firing up Windows Explorer, and in its address bar, I'm going to type percent, capital TMP, percent. That's a shortcut that basically leads to the temporary folder for the currently signed in account. And you'll see, indeed, that there are a lot of temporary files. You can see this is my local account, users Leon AppData local temp. And there's temporary folders, lots of temporary files, you get the idea. And if you take a look down in the lower corner here, you'll see that there are 50 items here. The folders in this list count as one item, but the concept is that, yeah, there's some stuff in here. And it may have been left behind for a variety of reasons. Let's look at some of those. Crashes. This is perhaps one of the biggest ones. Regardless of what a program is using a temporary file for, if the program doesn't shut down normally, in other words, it just sort of crashes, then it doesn't have the opportunity to clean things up. Now, some programs will clean them up the next time they're run, but I'd guess that most don't do that. They leave the temporary files alone and create a new set the next time that they're run. And it's important to understand that Windows itself is a program that uses temporary files. If Windows crashes, it too will not have the opportunity to clean up. An improper shutdown can also leave temporary files behind. When you think about it, if you've ever had to long press the power button to shut down Windows, that actually behaves a lot like a crash. Whatever was in use at the time remains. A normal shutdown, using either shutdown or restart, will give the operating system the chance to clean up on the way out. Of course, if a program is currently running and it uses temporary files, you'll see those. There's a lot of software running on your machine at any time, and whether you see it or not, there's a lot of stuff running around in the background, and they may in fact use temporary files. Temporary files can be the result of applications that you never see. Now, Windows and other software updates may leave behind temporary files to assist with rollback or uninstalls. It's important because what happens is when you perhaps uninstall or roll back an update, Windows then goes and finds the old copies of whatever files were updated and replaces them. But until that happens, those old copies are essentially temporary files. You can delete them if you wanted to, and in fact, we'll look at some ways to do that. But all that really means is that once they're deleted, you won't be able to do the rollback. Caches are an interesting problem. Caches are basically folders that contain files that the application is saving or using to make its operation faster. We've talked a lot about browser caches, the fact that if you visit the same page or you need to download the same graphic over and over again, rather than doing it over and over again, the browser will take it once and keep it in a cache. That way, the next time you need to use the exact same image or the exact same page, it doesn't have to go online and the result is much faster. The same is true for a lot of different programs. For example, there are programs that I run that the first time you run them, they actually go through, I'll call it a pre-calculation. They actually do a fair amount of work that takes a little bit of time, but once they're done, that's then preserved for subsequent runs of the program. Those are sometimes saved as temporary files. The only downside of deleting those is that the program needs to repeat its initialization the next time it's run. Some programs make logs of particular actions or other things as they do their job. We might think that the event log is a place where those things belong, and maybe they do, maybe they don't. The event log is a whole nother discussion. But sometimes applications simply log information to files they create themselves, temporary files. That again, they're available for as long as you might need to examine the logs, but if you delete them, the only thing that's happening is that you no longer have access to those logs. Now, one of the things I've got to mention, and ultimately I will claim that it's probably the second most common reason people think of when they look at these long lists of temporary files, and that's simply poor programming. Sometimes the application uses the system's temporary file location when an app-specific solution might be more appropriate. In the caching example I was just talking about, you might want the application to save that in an application-specific folder that it can then manage on its own. Otherwise, some of them put them into the system temp folder, which means they might get unexpectedly deleted or, in severe cases, might be damaged by other programs. And sometimes it's just bad code. Sometimes software is written to use and create temporary files without thinking through all of the scenarios where they should be cleaned up. Now, there is another way to view and clean up temporary files. Let's have a look at that. Go ahead and I'm going to leave this window open so that we can see what the temporary files are on this system. I'm going to fire up the Settings app, and I'm actually going to search for temporary. And we'll click on Delete Temporary Files. Now, what it's doing first is it's calculating how much space each of these categories is taking up. Temporary files on this machine isn't really taking up a whole lot of space, but we'll look at it anyway. If I click on it, it will then give me a more detailed list of what kinds of temporary files there are on this system, what they mean, and whether or not you might want to clean them up. You can see there are a lot of categories here, and I'm not going to walk through each one, but they probably will look a little bit familiar. There are log files, there are thumbnails, there are caches, there's a whole bunch of stuff. And you can select which ones you may or may not want to delete. It's up to you. It is, to be clear, safe to delete everything that's listed here. I will point out here that it's not necessarily safe to delete everything that's listed here. Almost everything is just fine. Delete it all you want. But the thing you definitely want to pay attention to is this item here that says Downloads. Your Downloads folder is, in a sense, considered a folder full of temporary files. You download them, you move them to where you want them, or you run them once, and then you're done with them. Emptying the download folder is considered one way of freeing up space used by temporary files. You'll see that it's unchecked here, but it's something that you'll want to pay attention to make sure you're not losing something important to you. I'll click on Remove Files. going to go ahead and purging a bunch of stuff, and it's done. If I go over here and hit F5, well, not a whole lot has changed. And that's part of the confusion. That is the fact that a lot of these files that are currently in my temp folder are in use. There's some application, probably the system itself, that's actually using these files. Now, another approach to cleaning these files up that you've probably looked into before is simply Windows Disk Cleanup. I'm going to go ahead and run Disk Cleanup. It first does an analysis of the drive you're looking for. And you can see here, there are a bunch of things that it can clean up. Most of these are unchecked because we just cleaned up a lot of them, but there's a lot more here that we may want to take care of. System files are treated separately. You'll note that the temporary folder that we looked at was unique to my user account. Each user account has its own temporary folder. Windows has its own set of temporary files and folders. So that's why this is a separate step to delete or clean up system files. But those are two ways you can free up some space, clean up temporary files. More importantly, though, now you know where they came from, why they exist, and whether or not you should worry about them. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/173949. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.